Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Aditya 11TTT. Today we are going to show you how to assemble the MRT Ultra card on our motherboard. Before entering into the motherboard session, I would like to suggest you to read the configuration which is been required to this card, and we will be mentioning the description link below where you can get all the details of what kind of motherboard and system is required to run this particular card. This here we are taking it for an example. So this is our PCI 2.0 card, and you know this is PCI 2.0. So what we will be doing, we will be placing this card on this particular port, PCI Express port over here. So we will be placing it over here. Okay, now we have placed this particular card on this PCI Express port, that is 2.0. Now you can see over here, here it is written power in. Here you can see it is written over here power in. These two particular terminals you can say takes the input of your SMPS. So what we are going to do is we have to put the terminal of SMPS over here. This is required. The supply will be required over here, so we will be placing it over here. So we will be placing it over here, and second one also we will be placing it. So this is the two ports which will be used, which will be taking the power. Okay. Now you can see over here, this is power out. That indicates that two channel, that is channel 2 and 3, is being controlled by this power section, and channel 0 and 1 is being controlled by this power section. Okay, now this particular port, this is your nothing but a SATA power port, which will be supplying the power to the hard disk over here. So for this particular portion, we have a separate set of cable over here that I already showed you in our previous video. You can check it over there. This is our cable. So what we are going to do is we are going to place all the cables, that is four cable, over here. Now we have placed this four cable over here, and I already told you there is an indicator to make you understand which channel you are using. Like this is 3 channel, so I have connected it with the channel number 3 over here. You can see there are channel 0, 1, 2 and 3 written over here. 0, 1, 2 and 3. So we will be using the cable as it is written. It is just to avoid the confusion, nothing else. Okay. The next is we are going to place your SATA cable on here. There are 4 port over here, you can see. 4 port, we are going to place the SATA cable here as well. Now we have placed the SATA cable over here. You can see 4 SATA cable port I have placed over here. Now this will be connected to your SATA power. This will be acting as your SATA power, and this particular will be acting as your data line as it acts on the desktop or laptop part. Now one thing I would like to tell you, this all the terminals over here 0, 1, 2 and 3 is being controlled by the software. Okay, so you don't need to worry about which terminal has to be connected with what. Whatever you connect, you have to give the command on the software and it will be working through the software only. The power over here will be always stable. As soon as you give the command, the power will be passing to the particular required terminal and it will start working. One more thing over here, in this particular card there is the ID port also. This is your ID port, which will also be operated by the particularly the software. Now we will be moving to the terminal part over here, and I have already told you there are total 8 terminals available, and each terminal is of for different company. You can see over here, it is written over here, the first one is for Western Digital, the second one is for the Seagate, the third one is for the Samsung, and the last two are one for Fujitsu and one for your Toshiba. Now you can see here, there are two types of terminal over here. One for, this is both for the WD only, but here you can see the pins are different. So accordingly you have to use the pins for which hard disk, according to the hard disk, whichever hard disk is present to you, accordingly you have to use the terminal parts. So we will be speaking about the terminal converter also. So this, we have a terminal converter, and we will be using it for the cable. Let me remove this thing that we will be covering up later on. Now we have two cables for that, because it has a two terminal ports over here. You can see there are two ports, and one thing I would like to mention over here, the dot over here, you can see this is pin number one, here also pin number one. You should not be mistaken about the pin number 1 configuration. The dot indicates the pin number 1 over here. Similarly, if we talk about this particular cable, this red mark, as you can see, this red mark is your pin number 1. So while connecting this red, you have to make sure that you connect it to the pin number 1 of this particular port. So we are connecting it over here. So you can see over here, we have connected pin number 1 in respect to pin number 1 only. So this is our pin number 1 over here. You can see we have connected it. Now here also you have to take care of the pin configuration. Here you can see this is pin number 1 over here. Similarly, when you connect the terminal part over here, you have to take care of the certain things, that is your pin number 1 configuration. Now how will you identify the pin number 1 over here? You can see this is a square mark, rest is round. Let me clear it for you. Let me clear so that you can understand. You can see over here, this is pin number 1. You can see this is a square mark that indicates pin number 1. Here also it is square, pin number 1. Here also it is square, pin number 1. And here also it is square, pin number 1 over here. So you can see it has been indicating the pin number 1 over here. Now what you have to do, you have to just do the connection with this particular cable, just taking care of pin number 1 configuration. So what we are going to do is, we are going to see the pin number 1 over here and we will be making the connection. So we have made the connection over here. You can see this red mark is pin number 1 over here, and this is pin number 1 over here, and this is contacted with this particular thing. Similarly, here also you have to take care. You can see on the terminal part also, backside, you can find the pin number 1 configuration. You can see this is your pin number 1. The square indicates that it is your pin number 1. Rest you can see it is all round. The square indicates pin number 1, that will be going to your hard disk. So similarly, here also you can see the pin number 1 is your square part. You can see over here that it is your square part, pin number 1, and according to that you will be connecting it to your hard disk. So we will be using this particular cable, this is your cable, USB cable, with the terminal to connect both of them and this particular UART part to the hard disk to make a complete connection. So you can see over here, we have connected it with the help of a USB cable over here, and this is to be connected to the hard disk. Now we will be talking about the BIOS reading. This particular reading also has the pin number 1 thing. Let me explain you so that you don't get confused while putting the chip. You all can see over here, there is an arrow mark which has been made on this particular box. It is indicating a round over here. This indicates this particular box. This box, your left hand side top first pin is your pin number 1. So when you put this particular chip, you have to take care of putting the pin number 1 to pin number 1 itself. You should make sure that pin number 1 is attached to pin number 1 only, or it may result in shorting of the particular IC or damaging the PCB also. So you can see it has been connected with pin number 1. Here is the marking over here, and this has been connected to pin number 1 over here. Now for that thing, we are having this cable, and as I told you, this is a pin number 1 over here, this red color mark. So we will be placing it over here. You can see here is a mark over here, JP2 is over already over here. So we will be putting the cable over here. Here also you will find a configuration backside. I'll try to show you, although the camera is shaky over here, but I'll try to show you. See over here, this is a square signal over here. This is your pin number 1. So basically you have to connect it like this. But you don't have to worry on this particular part, because it has a marked over here and it will easily be adjusted. You can see over here, it has been adjusted without any problem because it has a cut over there. So you don't have to worry about pin number 1 on this particular thing. Similarly, here also you can see on the other hand, there is a cut over here. So it will be easily fitting up over here. You can see over here, it has been already adjusted over here. And you can see over here, this is pin number 1 over here, the square wave. So this indicates that pin number 1 is being connected to pin number 1 only, nowhere else. And we have already connected. Now this terminal will also be operated by the software of the MRT. This will create a terminal connection, and by the commands of the software, this particular terminal will be running, and reading and writing of the BIOS will be taking place of the hard disk. So this is how the working of BIOS reading through this cable and this board will take place. Now let me show you something. Different motherboards of the hard disk. This is your motherboard of the hard disk. Okay, now here you can see the chip of the BIOS is a bit thicker than this one. This is just like a very thin chip. You can see it is very thin. I'll try to show you removing it. Okay, I'll try to compare it both together that you can understand more better. You can feel that this is a thinner chip and this is a thicker chip. How will you confirm that this is a BIOS chip? You don't have to do anything. You have to just take this number, type the number in the Google, and you will get your answer over there. This is a serial ROM only, and you can get all the details on the Google when you search it. Now moving to the hard disk part, how will you connect the hard disk? So here you can see, this is the hard disk. This is a demo hard disk I have already opened. You can see it is totally deteriorated, but it's okay for understanding. You can see this is the motor over here. This is middle part is the motor. This is the plate which has the you can say the data stored. This is nothing but your head, or you can call it as a lens over here. Okay, now this particular thing will be reading your data and transferring your data from this cable, from this particular device, and this will be transferring data via this to this end. This is your reading writing of data. Now, as I told you, over here you can see this is a SATA port. So we will be connecting the SATA port, and this is UART terminal over here. This is a WD, so we will be using a WD terminal to connect this. Now you can see we have connected the terminal over here. So we have connected the CS3 channel over here. You can see over here, this is CS3. So we are using the third channel, that is the fourth one. Now we have connected the power, we have connected the interface of SATA, which will be reading the data, and lastly we have connected the terminal, UART terminal over here. Now this completes up with the installation, that is offline installation, how you make the connection of this particular card. Now this is the process of installation. Rest the card will be controlled via the software, and the software will be controlling all your signals on this card, and accordingly it will be working. So this was all about the MRT Ultra card installation. I'd like to thank all our viewers for watching our channel Aditya 11 Triple T. So keep on hitting the subscribe button, like, share and comment. Thanks a lot.